to bring in criminal defense attorney Nick Fortuna to talk more about this. Also with us, CNN political reporter Rebecca Berg. Nick, Daniel's attorney told Anderson Cooper that this whole idea that Trump did not know anything about the payments to his client is, quote, patently absurd. Do you believe that?
Oh, of course. I mean, I think Trump has lost this suit before it's even started. As far as the restraining order is concerned, that his personal attorney tried to get while obscuring the fact that it's on behalf of Trump, renders the restraining order invalid. The agreement itself that they entered into allows for the parties to go to court. So I think poor lawyering from the start, you know, gave Stormy Daniels an opportunity to go to court and ask the court to review the situation and see if she's bound by the agreement. I think her attorney's correct. She's more likely than not going to be bound by this agreement. Not only did he not sign the agreement, there are plenty of opportunities, the way the agreement was written, for her to speak out about certain matters that are not going to be covered by the agreement. And I agree that Sarah Sanders basically confirmed the involvement of Trump with Stormy Daniels.
Okay, and so when you hear Sarah Sanders, I wonder just what you think about this, where she's talking about this arbitration. It's something that you mentioned Michael Cohen's trying to get, but she's talking about what's supposed to be a secret court order, and it's just, I mean, this sort of defies the whole point of it, right? It's clearly not secret anymore.
Right, and it's silly for them to think that it would be secret, because any arbitration order is subject to confirmation by a court, and that's what I meant by poor lawyering. They didn't handle this properly, that how these disputes would be managed in the future, and it does allow for the parties to go to court, and in the agreement itself, it allows the parties to ask that any filings be sealed. So that gives implicit permission for Stormy Daniels or even Trump or anyone else to file an action without it being under seal and disclosing what the nature and the substance of the dispute is. So I really think that, you know, this is maybe a slow-moving train wreck for Trump in this case, because he's not going to have the opportunity to keep this quiet.
Rebecca and Nick, thank you to both of you.